Now here's a fascinating variation on the low temperature Stirling engine theme. It's called a Ross Yoke and uses a rather clever linkage to ensure the 90 degree phase shift between the displacer and the power piston. I think that's rather clever. It's been running for about half an hour now on this mug of hot water. And it's showing off its slow speed running capability quite well. You can see the motion of the linkage a lot better at this speed. The left one is the power cylinder and the right one is the displacer. Flywheel is attached to the bit at the bottom of the triangle there. Bit at the top just goes up and down, guided by the link at the top there. The top and bottom plates are actually made of perspex in this particular model, which means you can see the displacer going up and down 90 degrees phase with the power piston. Also means you can see the hot water, the steam from the hot water condensing on the bottom plate. I did think at first that the plastic top and bottom plates would have impeded the working of the engine, and that they're not as conductive as metal plates, but I was surprised at how quickly it started going. Plates are about 3 millimeters thick, something like that, about an eighth of an inch. It is running remarkably smoothly at this very slow speed. Must be about 40 minutes after I started. I don't know how slow this is going to go. can't go much slower. Can it? It's now almost stopping at the top of each stroke. So I don't think it's going to go much slower. But even so, it's remarkably smooth. I keep saying this can't go much slower, but it does. And this is about 45 minutes from the start. And one mug full of hot water. And I have to say that this was straight out of the box. No optimization by me or anything. Just needed to attach the flywheel, which came detached through the post. Came all the way from Malaysia. Very well packed, actually. And it's working remarkably well. Very, very low friction by the looks of it. Without a doubt, this is the best slow speed performance of any of my engines, steam or otherwise. Only just making it over top dead center, and you all said that about 5 minutes ago. Yeah, finally, it failed to make it over top dead center. That's just about an hour after I started it up on this. It's just dropped down to bottom dead center. Yeah, that's all on one. An hour's running on one mug of hot water. I think that's an impressive performance. I'm quite happy with that.